Welcome back, Toy Fans, to episode 219 of Reynolds Reviews. And on today's episode, we're adding some more Bill and Ted's Excellent Adventure line to the collection room. Cue the match. Welcome back, everyone. Now, like I said in the intro, today we are adding some more Bill and Ted's Excellent Adventure toy line from Kennett to the collection room. Now, if you know me and you follow the channel closely, you'll know that at the moment I'm adding so many new toy lines to the collection, and Bill and Ted's Excellent Adventure is another one. I've already added the Jam Sessions 2-pack. You may have seen that a few months ago. Today we're adding some more figures from the standard release, but watch till the end because these figures are also another part of another Reynolds Wheel and Deal that I've put together recently as well, and we're going to see if that was successful. So let's get to it.
Bill and Ted's Excellent Adventure!
I'm Bill S. Preston Esquire!
And I'm Ted Theodore Logan!
In concert!
And I make them play!
Speaker connects to figures and most cassette players to make figures play music!
Now on drums, that bodacious barbarian Genghis Khan!
Yeah, our new pal from old China!
Excellent!
Let's rock and roll!
Squeezing their legs gets them jamming!
Bill and Ted's Excellent Adventure!
Party on, dudes!
Okay, folks, and there we go. So there's only one place to start, and that's with Bill and Ted themselves. Now, unfortunately, I don't have every figure in this line. I am missing a couple, but we are going to look at these guys today. Now, I've got these guys loose, so we can look at these guys in the card and loose as well. But I don't have them all. I've got some on card, and I haven't got them loose, so we're going to have to look at those on the card in the bubble. But I just love this line. I think the packaging is beautiful. I love those cards. They look absolutely amazing. I think the blue, the pink and the yellow work so well. And then we've got that huge pink background in the bubble. I just think it's so beautiful. But like I said, there was only 7 figures released in this standard line. And before I look at these boys any further, because we are going to look at them out of the packaging as well, let's just show you the other figures that were available in this line. Yeah, there we go, folks. Like I said, only 7 figures released in the standard line. They were the other 5, but I love these guys. The back of the cards are nice as well. As you can see, it shows you all the other figures that were released. It also has a little bio of the particular character on the back there. It has Bill's tape offer, and I just think these are absolutely superb. They look great on the shelf. Like I said, I'm really pleased to get these in my collection. So let's get the loose figures on the table, and we'll take a closer look at these guys. Okay, folks, so we're going to start with Ted Theodore Logan, my personal favourite. I'm a big fan of Keanu Reeves, and I just love this guy. And I love these figures. And you know what? To say the sort of, I'm not sure if these are based on the movie or based on the comic books, but I actually don't think these sculpts are bad at all. I think the likeness to the actors are actually quite good. And I just think they're really cool looking figures, nice and vibrant with their colours. And I just think they really do look nice. So as you can see, we've got Ted Theodore Logan with his neon shorts there. He's got his waistcoat on, that trademark sort of almost bowl cut hairdo, and I just think this guy is great. So he's got his purple electric guitar, as you can see, and then, like the Jam Sessions figures, if you squeeze the legs, the play feature is they start jamming on their guitar, and I just think these are so cool, man. I really do. But just spin this guy around, you can see on his back, he's got a very cool Wild Stallions logo on the back of his waistcoat, and then he's got his plug-in point as well. Now, just an update on the Jam Sessions video. So I was a little bit confused how that all worked. And I believe now the tape and the amp set is actually meant to work with a Walkman, and I tried it with a tape player, so I am going to have to update that. But the plug-in feature on the back of these figures, I believe, are just for visual effects. So I don't actually think it does anything. I think you just plug them in, and it's just for show to make them look like they're plugged into the amp, which kind of makes sense. But yeah, this is 10th Theodore Logan. Really, really love it. And I'm so pleased to get them into my collection. Not easy to find. You can get them on eBay, but not always readily available. And often you can find the figure without the guitar. So again, not always easy to get your hands on complete. But really pleased to have this one in my collection. But let's move on to his partner in crime, which is Bill. And there we've got Bill S. Preston Esquire. And again, looking very, very cool. And again, I think quite a good likeness to Alex Winter. I just think they've done a really good job with these figures. Like I say, I'm not entirely sure if they're based on the movie characters or the comic book characters, but I think they've done a real good job with the sculpt. So this guy's got his red and white baseball shoes on. Looks like he's got sort of jeans on. I don't know if they're sort of jeans or sort of jogging pants. And then a very cool white Wild Stallions t-shirt there with the big logo on. And I just think this guy looks really cool. And I personally prefer Bill's guitar with these figures. I think that orange sort of V-shaped guitar is really cool. Just looks so nice. And then his head's a bit loose, so it keeps moving. And then the jamming feature is the same. So squeeze the legs and they start jamming. So yeah, really cool. And again, on the back, you can see they've got the plug-in feature. And like I said, now I believe that is just purely for show. I thought it must mean, you know, it must do something when I was using it with the jam sessions. But yeah, I just think they're very cool figures. They look great on the shelf. And if you're a Bill and Ted fan, I think you've got to have these in your collection. I really do. So I'm really pleased to add them to the Bill and Ted collection. But there is some more figures to come, folks. So let's move on. Okay, folks. And now we've got Abraham Lincoln, or Abe Lincoln, as the card states. So you'll remember in the movie, Abraham Lincoln is one of the historical figures that they grab for their history project. And I haven't got this one loose, so I'm going to have to show you him in the bubble only. But it's just so cool. I love his accessory, the fact that he comes with a bright yellow keyboard. I think that's great. But as you can see, all the historical figures, they've got like a sort of a different set. So when you take his hat off, for example, you can see he's got a big high top hair with the Wild Stallions logo in it. And all the figures have got like their normal clothes, their historical figure clothes, and then they sort of go into Wild Stallions mode. And so Abraham Lincoln would take his hat off, and then he's got Wild Stallions logo on his hair, and he's ready to play the keyboard. But again, I just think this is really cool. And again, these aren't easy to get in the UK. Now, I will say it again at the end, but I need to give a massive, massive shout out and big thank you to our VTR Dave, because he helped me get these figures. These figures came from the US. I don't think there was any other way I was going to get them in the UK if he hadn't helped me. So massive thank you to VTR Dave. He is good to me. He always helps me out loads. But yeah, this guy is cool. So obviously the play feature on this guy is when you would squeeze his legs, the same as the other guys, then both his arms go up and down to imitate like he's playing the keyboard. And I just think these figures are great. The only surprise, which we will get to later, I'll talk about it a little bit more later, the only surprise is that we only got three historical figures in this line. But we're going to move on quickly because I've got a few more to show you, and the next one is also very cool. And the next one, folks, is Genghis Khan. And I think this is a really cool one. So this guy comes with a couple of weapons, but also a big club that can be used as a drumstick. And as you can see, he comes with some Wild Stallions drums. And his feature, if you can just see in the top corner there, his armor comes off and he's sporting a very nice cropped Wild Stallions top. And his play feature, he squeezes the legs and he beats the drums. And I just think they're such a cool line. I think the play feature is really nice. Like I said, you know, they all have the same play feature, but they use different instruments. I just think it's a really cool gimmick. But yeah, and what I love about Genghis Khan, especially in the movie, I love it when he goes crazy and kicks himself out and goes mental in the sporting goods store. So yeah, like I said, as you saw earlier in the video, they did release Billy the Kid. I don't have that one to show you, unfortunately. And they did release Rufus, which would be a really good one to get. Unfortunately, I don't have him to show you either. But I have got one more figure to show you. And this is where the line goes a little strange for me. And I will explain why. Okay, folks. And now we get to the last character that I've picked up. And this is the Grim Reaper. Now, this is where it gets weird for me, and I will explain a little bit more about that in a second. But let's look at the figure first, and I've got to admit, I do think the figure is absolutely wicked. I really do love how they've done this. They've got soft goods, we've got his big cape there, soft goods, with a hood that does go nicely over his head. as you can see, but I'm going to show you with it down. It does go nicely over his head, but obviously I like it down to reveal that lovely blue mohawk and of course that very, very cool Wild Stallions logo tattooed on the side of his head. But it's just such a cool figure, man. I really do love it. I love the fact that they've got his big scythe there, and then you can't see it, it is hooked on his back, but he has a very, very cool skull style guitar, and I just think this guy is absolutely wicked. And I do think it's a great figure. I think it looks fantastic, it displays great, but I'll tell you for me where the confusion comes in, because I think this was a really strange addition to this line, and I will explain why. Now, it's quite long-winded and complicated, folks, so try to stay with me. So I thought immediately this was a really strange choice to put in the Excellent Adventure line, because obviously we never had a Grim Reaper character in the Excellent Adventure movie.
What?
But we did have one in the Bogus Journey movie, but of course Bogus Journey came after Excellent Adventure, which seems confusing to why you would add this to this toy line. However, the Excellent Adventure movie came out in 89, the Bogus Journey movie came out in 91, and this figure line came out in 91. So somebody somewhere around Kenner and the Bill and Ted line knew that a Grim Reaper character was coming. So maybe thought, let's add a Grim Reaper line to the toy line. I don't necessarily have an issue with that, because like I said, I love the character. But what I find even stranger than that is they seem to have based this figure more focused on the way the Grim Reaper looked in the Bogus Journey comics, not the movie. Now, if you're going to add the Grim Reaper to this line, for me, you've got to portray it like from the movie. So even though I love this character, for me, I think it would have been a far better idea if you're going to add this character to this toy line, he's got to portray William Sadler from the Bogus Journey movie. I think it would have been much better.
Damn right!
So I just think this is a really strange addition, even though I love it. I think to add it to the Excellent Adventure line when we didn't have a Grim Reaper character in that movie, even though the toy line and Bogus Journey movie was released in the same year, if you're going to add it, then at least it's strange to then portray it as the comic book version of, in the Bogus Journey comics rather than the film version. I just think that was a really, really strange one, and I think it's very confusing with the timeline, etc. But as much as I love this character, this figure, I think it would have been a better idea to portray it as the actor from the Bogus Journey movie. But I've got to admit, I do love it. And a big, big shout out, because I didn't get this in the bundle that VTR helped me with. I bought this from the NEC from my good friend Steve, better known as Derby Collector. He sold this to me while I was at the NEC, and I absolutely love it. But what a strange decision to put into the toy line. I just think it's really odd. However, we're not done yet. We've got one more thing to show you, and then I'm going to get everything wrapped up, get it back on the table, give you a little bit more info, and then explain to you about the deal that I did with this lot. And there we go, folks. So in the bundle, or in the job lot that I picked up, I also picked up a carded amp and cassette set. Now, you will have seen these loose on the Jam Sessions 2-pack video, because you do get them in with that set, but you can also get them separately on their own like this, and I'm really, really pleased to get these. Not easy to get either. And as you can see, there's a picture on the top there of the card, and it shows you this set working with a Walkman, and I'm pretty sure you've got to set it up specifically with a Walkman, not a tape player like I tried to do. So I think that's where my mistake was, folks. I may have to update the Jam Sessions video, but just really nice to have a set on the card. The card, like I said, it's a bit beaten up. It has seen better days, but just nice to have it on a card. The bubble's nice and secure, and it is nice and clear as well, so really happy to have that. That will display great with my carded figures. So I just wanted to show that, even though you have seen it before, that you can get it specifically separate on its own card, and I just think it's really cool. But I am going to get everything back on the table now. I'm going to give you some more info first, and then I'm going to wrap up the video by telling you about the Whelan deal that I did, and we'll see if I was successful. Okay, folks, so there we go, everything back on the table. And before I wrap up the video and tell you about the deal I made, I'm just going to give you a little bit more info about this line and things that I find quite interesting. So if you've seen the Excellent Adventure movie, you will know that the boys bring back 8 historical figures for their history project. Yet in the toy line, we actually only get 3. So as you can see on the table, we've got Abraham Lincoln, we've got Genghis Khan, and they also released Billy the Kid, which unfortunately I don't have. But 5 characters that we never got in the line was Sigmund Freud. Now that would have been a really good one to have. I think that would have lent itself really good to an action figure. We never got Joan of Arc. Now again, I don't know if there's any issues with female action figures back then, whether they thought they wouldn't sell well. We never got Socrates or Socrates, as they say in the movie. Again, maybe not a huge amount of playability in that one. One that I did find strange, we never got Beethoven, or Beethoven as they say, because the film is about two guys, or two high school nerds that want to be in a successful band, yet Beethoven was the only actual musician in the historical figure, so you would think they'd have included him. And my personal favourite, Napoleon. I absolutely love Napoleon as a character. I think he's portrayed brilliantly in the movie. I love the way he's portrayed, and I think it was Deacon who said it best.
You ditched Napoleon? Deacon, do you realise you have stranded one of Europe's greatest leaders in San Dimas?
He was a dick.
I just think Napoleon was fantastic. But Napoleon was due to be part of this toy line. He was produced. In fact, he's even advertised on the back of the Jam Sessions 2-pack and in toy catalogues back in that year, but unfortunately the line was cancelled before he hit the shelves. So I think that's really interesting. But again, also, we did have some vehicles and play sets that were due to be released in the line, but again, never hit the shelves before the line was cancelled. So we did get like a twin motorcycle set. So we've got a picture of the guys in like a twin motorcycle. We also got like a car. It was almost like a Trans Am. In a Bill and Ted style. We also got a boom truck, and we even got a historical playset, so a huge playset with all the historical worlds that I think would have been awesome, but none of these were ever produced and hit the shelves, and I just think, wow, how awesome would they have been if they'd have hit the shelves for this toy line, but unfortunately produced but never released, which is a real shame for me. But okay, I'm going to get everything back on the table. I'm going to wrap up and tell you about the deal I made. Okay, folks, so there we go. So as you can see, that's pretty much what I had on the table a second ago, but you will notice that I've added two soundtracks. So we've got the Bill and Ted's Excellent Adventure soundtrack and Bogus Journey soundtrack on cassette tape. They were part of the job lot that I picked up. Now, I'm going to put a picture on screen now. So this is the job lot that I spotted. Now, again, massive thanks to VTR Dave, because this was in the US and he helped me get this in hand. But as you can see, in that job lot, there is more than what I've showed you today, but that's because I've already moved on half of it. So when I spotted that job lot, I thought, right, I want the four carded figures out of that. I want the carded speaker and tape set. I want the two cassette tape soundtracks and everything else I can move on. There's two Jam Sessions packs there, but I've already got one. So the plan was to pay £165 for that job lot. When I got it, sell the two Jam Sessions 2-packs, because I've already got one, sell the unopened trading cards that are in there, sell the comics, and tried to get all my money back to essentially get the things into my collection that I wanted to keep from that job lot for free. So let me tell you about the deal that I did. So when I got that job lot in hand, I sold the two Jam Sessions packs. Now, I sold those both for £70 each, so that's £140. Then my good friend Adam Berry took my trading cards off me. Now, he loves a trading card, as Adam. Adam gave me £30 for the unopened box of trading cards, so that was £170. And then I managed to sell all the comics for £25. So that actually made me £195, and I still kept all the carded figures, the two cassette tapes and the speaker and tape set back for myself. I took £15 out of that £195 for postage, because it cost me £15 to post everything to people that bought from me, which left me at £180. So I'm sorry to make you do maths on a Sunday, but I'm sure you'll have already worked it out. So the whole lot cost me £165. I kept all the carded figures that I wanted to keep. I kept the speaker and tape set carded set. I kept the two cassette tape soundtracks. So essentially, I got all those figures and the tapes into my collection for free, and I actually made a profit of £15. So what an absolutely unbelievable deal. So that is a Reynolds Wheel and Deal success. Now, I've said before, because my budget is so modest, I've kind of got to do these things now. On this occasion, again, it's worked out. But I've said before, you can do it. Sometimes opportunities come up. As long as you buy well and you make educated decisions and you make calculated risks, you know, it can be done. So like I said, everything on the table, you can see there, I've got into my collection for absolutely free and even made £15 profit. Now, obviously, I'm not counting these loose figures because I've picked these up separately to this job lot. I'm talking about the carded stuff you can see, the two cassette tapes and the speaker and tape carded set. But yeah, I put them into my collection for free and made a profit of £15. So there you go, folks. It can be done if you buy well and you make calculated decisions and take calculated risks, educated decisions. It can be done on it. Not only can it be done on a budget, you can make money. So there we go, folks. I think you'll agree that was a success. Bit of a long one this week. I hope you stayed with me, but thank you if you did. If you're new to the channel, thanks for stopping by and giving me a shot. I hope you consider leaving a like and subscribing. And if you're one of my existing viewers and subscribers, I say it all the time, folks, but I really do mean it. Thank you for sticking with me. It really does mean a lot. Leave any comments or questions in the comment section below. I always try to read everyone's comments and get back to everybody. And as always, keep collecting and be excellent to each other. See you next time, folks.